Okay, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Let me introduce myself. My name is Tsania ilma rahmawati. I am from biology of Rinsi 2019. I would like to present about what polar bears and astronauts have in common. The first, I would like to explain the topics. The first topic is what is hibernation. The second is what causes it and on bears to truly hibernate. And the third is, could human do this someday? Okay, next. Okay, first is what is hibernation. Hibernation, condition of period of an animal or plant spending the winter in a dormant state. But according to Corey Williams at the University of Alaska, Fairbanks says hibernation is a seasonal state of inactivity and suppressed metabolism during which body temperature drops below levels. Okay, next, about animal that hibernate. There are 12 animals that hibernate. The first is moth. Moth have several strategies to survive the cold winter. Some species lay their eggs in late summer or fall, which don't hatch until the following spring when food is plentiful. Many moths spend the winter as caterpillars, hibernating through vegetation, although some don't emerge to feed during mild periods. The next is bat. Okay. Hibernating bats make it through such a deep slumber, which can last over 6 months, on only a few grams of stored fat. They accomplish this by dropping their body temperature and slowing their metabolism to the point where heart rates wind down to a mere 10 beats a minute. The third is bear. I will explain about bear in the next slide. The fourth is bumblebees. Hibernation can take up a large amount of a bumblebee life, and some queen bees can hibernate for 9 months, almost 3/4 of their life. Going into hibernation is important because it protects the queen from the rigors of life above ground, with the risk of predation, starvation, and diseases. To hibernate, queen bees dig into well-drained soil, usually on north-facing banks. This varies between species, but it's true that they choose north-facing banks because if they were south-facing, they would be exposed to the low winter sun, which could heat the soil and bring the bees out of hibernation before spring arrives. Staying in banks probably helps them avoid being flooded. As does the well-drained soil, they dig down about 10 centimeters or more and excavate a little hole in which they will spend the winter, surviving temperatures down to -19°C. Okay, the fourth, the fifth is snail. Some snail hibernate during the winter, typically October through April in the northern hemisphere. They may also activate in the summer in drought condition to stay moist during hibernation. A snail seals its shells opening with a dry layer of mucus called an epiphragm. The sixth is groundhog. This is groundhog. Okay. Groundhogs, during hibernation, live in underground burrows that they dig, may observe piles of dirt near the den. Throughout the winter, they are inactive, their heart rate low, and their body temperature drop to approximately 39 to 40 degrees Fahrenheit. So, this is a several-month process extending from late October to early February, depending on their geographic location. The next is ladybug. Ladybug will begin scouring building in search of cracks and holes through which they can get inside. Many will end up in homes, but it is best to put them back outside if you see them, because houses lack a suitable food source to sustain the ladybug until they begin their hibernation. During hibernation, ladybugs rely on their fat reserves to last them until the spring, when they can once again begin to hunt. And the second is hedgehog. Hedgehog usually hibernate from October or November through the March or April. Research has shown that each individual is likely to move nesting sites at least once during this period and so can sometimes be seen out and about. During mild winters, hedgehogs can remain active well into November and December. While in hibernation, the hedgehog's food supply comes from the fat stores it has built up over the summer. Eating enough before hibernation is vital, and this is when supplementary feeding can improve importance to hedgehogs. Okay, for the next, there are dormouse, garter snake, ground squirrel, and box turtle. I will explain in the next time if we have change, because I have only 10 minutes to explain my presentation. Okay, the next is different hibernation between bears and small mammals. In general, mammals that experience lower body temperature during hibernation, such as chipmunks and ground squirrels, awaken every few days to raise their body temperature, eat a bit, or urinate. Bears do not emerge for any of those activities. Instead, they live off the fat they have collected during the summer and autumn months and even recycle their metabolic waste. The urea produced is broken down to release nitrogen, which the bear's body uses to build protein and maintain its muscle mass and organ tissues. For this reason, people around the world have historically killed bears to use a substance created from its liver to dissolve gallstone without surgery. Okay, the next slide. The most popular hibernators. There are two types of bears. There are grizzly bear and black bear. They breed from May to July, but the embryos are only implanted around December, when the female has already been denning for around a month. Cubs are born around February. Spring changes everything. By mid-March, male bears start to emerge, followed by solitary females and then females with older cubs. Around mid-April or early May, new mothers finally bring their cubs out into the world for the first time. While a lot is known now, William says we still do not know exactly what is common between all hibernating animals. There is not an identified hibernation triggering molecule or anything like that in hibernating animals. Animals that hibernate tend to be species that occupy environments that periodically lack resources. But why some animals can hibernate and others can is not entirely clear. At the moment, the study of hibernation has and continues to contribute significantly to applications in the human world. For example, despite having twice the level of cholesterol as humans, bears do not suffer from hardening of the arteries. They are also able to maintain their bone mass during hibernation, and understanding this could have advanced the study of treating people with weak bones. Perhaps one day it will be the key in sending humans far off into space. Okay guys, that's all of my presentation. Thank you for watching my video. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.